So, May, which one's yours?
Scania B94. This is the sleeper cab, which has got the extra bit on the back where you can sleep. They also did it as a day cab, which didn't have that bit, so you couldn't sleep in it. It's the...
He doesn't know anything.
What colour is it, James?
What have you got there? Good.
James, bad news. The Dacia Sandero.
The what?
The Dacia Sandero is not coming to the UK.
Oh. Now, British car.
It won't change unless you change that.
Yeah, it won't change unless you change that. Now you're here again.
Where are you guys from? Australia?
James wasn't really enjoying his company. But then neither was Jeremy.
I didn't know you were the police.
Police, Reno police.
Well, I'm
police.
I just saw
spoiling the tires and the rev of the engine.
Oh no, sorry, my foot slipped off the clutch.
No, that's it. No, I don't buy that for a second.
Okay, sorry.
Oh dear.
I honestly believe that at some point on our long and torturous route, one of us would be killed. Probably wouldn't be Hammond though, because unlike us two, he at least could get a helmet which fitted.
The reason I don't ride a motorcycle is because I have a large brain.
No, you have a big
head. The reason why crash helmets are small is because people who wear them haven't got a brain. Otherwise, they'd have a car. Some say that his favourite all-time tune is Forever Autumn by Justin Hayward, and that he has the world's largest collection of pornographical material. All we know is he's not the Stig, but he is the Stig's lorry-driving cousin. Look, he's got a lorry driver's sun.
Oh, sunburn, I see, yes, yes.
He's really as big as American Stig.
Big Stig?
Yeah. Have you turned the traction control off?
Yes.
Have you ever done that in your life?
No.
I think it's very game of him to join in.
I want to do lots of revs. Steering wheel straight.
Oh.
Oh, cock.
You are such an imbecile.
What do you call that?
I overcorrected.
Cock. This is a massive oh cock. How can it have run out? That rain makes a really annoying noise on my Cullender helmet. And it comes through.
Meanwhile, in the Renault...
Come on! Spin! Oh, yes! Ah! Ow! It's this lorry driving, it turns out, is quite a lot harder than I thought.
Have you done something to your leg as well?
Yeah, the gear lever's gone up my arse.
Right, OK.
Moving on to our next award. It is now the Most Embarrassing Flirting on Television Award. In third place, James May, for this fantastic, sonorous approach when presented with two girls during our Alfa Romeo trip through Warwickshire.
I have been rescued and I haven't even broken down.
Well, then you don't get...
Hello.
Have you ever heard
it? Hello.
Okay, James.
What's the worst?
What was that?
I really... I've forgotten how bad it was.
You have to start with hello.
What's next?
Right, in second place, Jeremy Clarkson for this inept charm offensive on an American girl in our studio only the other week.
American.
You're American?
Oh.
You can't be, you're nowhere near fat enough.
It was direct, it
Is
was a compliment.
That flattering?
No, it was a compliment, but that's not the winning entry because the winner is Jeremy Clarkson interviewing Will Young. Oh. Here he is. Here he is, admiring his physique. Let's have a look. Let's remind ourselves of when the magic first bloomed for us all. Here it is.
Just got arms like pipe cleaners. You're quite trim, actually. I mean, not trim, fit.
Fight
fit. I'm saying all the wrong things. Strong.
You're giggling. Away we go. Oh.
Sadly, though, this was also too much for the U.S. government.
I just wanted to make sure that you guys are doing the documentary.
Oh, it is a documentary. It's not a like a fooling around show. No, it's a serious show.
Jeremy's sincerity wasn't convincing, and his hand gestures didn't help either.
Everything you said made it worse. At one point, I wanted to just...
They provided backup transport.
Excellent.
Excellent turned out to be the wrong word.
Ooh.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yes, that is a bit...
Oh, God, I don't think so.
It's slightly conspicuous.
That's born in the USA, evidently.
That's thunder and the village. Have you noticed there was a rumble of thunder and the village arrived?
We've got some road-legal but very sticky track tyres, which could be worth several seconds.
You're going to have to turn it round.
Well, that's going to take the rest of our lives.
Oh,
it's disappeared into the bloody dashboard.
I'm going to grab this camera so that you can actually see, hopefully, what has happened here.
Now, these are the buttons that change the gears. That's park, that's backwards, and that was forwards. And I promise you, I merely pressed it and my finger just disappeared.
Because this is a hard job, and I'm not just saying this to win favour with lorry drivers, it's a hard job. Change gear, change gear, change gear, check your mirrors, murder a prostitute, change gear, murder, check your... That's a lot of effort in a day.
Don't really know what I'm doing here, because I'm not very fashion conscious.
Your suit's ready. Here it is.
Thank you. That's very nice.
It's perfect. I'm measuring my biceps now. Tape measure's not long enough.
Yeah, of course.
No, of course
she leaves that tape measure under my armpit any longer, it'll rot.
So what can you blend with it?
I could blend you if I wanted to. But what I'm actually going to do under this high visibility shield here is blend some beef.
Beef.
Yes, beef. This is going to be a man's V8 smoothie that I'm going to make now. So I'm going to plonk that in there like that.
Is that beef still got bones in it?
Yes. And then I'm going to put some chilies in. Got a few chilies. This is Bovril. Because that's a V8 man's drink.
That's a collection of manly ingredients.
And yes, I haven't finished yet. Tabasco.
Nice touch.
That wasn't... Yeah.
Just a dash of that in there. And I think... For added bite, brick. This is actually a brick. Oh, it's broken, but there we are. I'll pop that in there. OK, this is the controls.
Oh, God! Tell me that's not an accelerator pedal.
Yes! Hang on a sec, there's just safety precautions.
Like it. Is it loud?
Is it loud, James? Yeah, of course it's loud. Are we ready? So, here we go!
This is in the kitchen at home, yeah?
You get the thing off, I'll prepare the glasses,
yes, of course.
The label.
So this is, it's like a manly smoothie cocktail array.
Exactly.
This is a moment.
Yes! Yes!
Wow!
Look at that!
That just is the business!
Fantastic and delicious. Right, are we ready?
What a creation.
Here we go.
Get some of the bits.
It needs a name.
We should give it a name. We should call it Desperate Shag in a Skip.
Try some of that.
Quick one, James. Round the back of the dust cart.
I think he likes it.
I've got the name for it.
What?
The Bloody Awful.
Have you tried it?
Yeah.
You haven't. Put it in, have you?
Yes.
Show me putting it in your mouth, because that will put test. That will put testes on your chest. That
it's
will.
Put hairs on my eyeballs.
I'm not sure this works. Look. No! No! It's dying on me! No, no! No! You!
Does understeer this lorry.
Now look what's happened. The whole town is turned out to paint Richard Hammond's bike pink. James and I are doing everything possible to stop them. Please, don't do this.
I've given up trying to tell them. And you missed a bit there that you mustn't do as well.
You can't just go...
Hang on, has he painted her own bike?
No, it isn't hers.
It's not her...
What's happened is she's got hold of this big paint and decided everything in the entire car park needs painting.
One of the most important factors in economy runs is lightness, which is why Jeremy and I had packed James's luggage.
Yeah, that's a paperweight, just in case.
You're really funny men.
But just think, what if you need
what
one
if
of
you
these?
Need a wishbone?
Yeah. If you run out of fuel and then a lorry driver needs a gearbox, you can give him one.
Because we've thought.
It's transaxle.
Come on, just help. You're spoiling an otherwise very, very interesting experiment.
Ben Jeremy arrived.
Fire!
You're on fire!
We got the next challenge, lads.
How can we be this rubbish?
Bây giờ mời người này, please.
May. May. You, stand up.
Thấy người điều khiển giao thông tay giang ngang thì như thế nào? Người này. Không đúng, phải chưa? Hai tay giang ngang là không phải là dừng lại mà phía bên tay phải. Bây giờ mời tiếp.
Oh, no.
Yes.
Khi đi ở trên đường thì phải thực hiện chuyển dần hay là chuyển ngay?
Always give way to the car from the right.
See, this is an ice scraper, okay? It's covered in Santa's pubes. It's got Saab written on it. £38.50.
What for that?
What?
It's given us an idea, this. See this? This is a plate of sick. I know it is, okay, utterly worthless, but if I just pop a BMW badge on it, £13.80.
It does work, this sort of branding. This wizard's sleeve, for instance. Absolutely worthless, but it bears a Ferrari badge, £45.
This pork sword.
James, don't go do the pork sword. This cock.
Has it got four rings on
it? This is something I've wanted to do. I've worked in television for 20 years, never had the chance yet, OK?
Back to the studio.
Hey, that's my line! That's what I wanted to say! May! May, you f***ed it! James!
Yeah, what I thought I'd do is put the fire out and then say...
Back to the studio.
In fact, James discovered there is a terrifying third way of stopping a big lorry.
Was it really that frightening?
Yes.
We've got another challenge.
I'm not interested.
As a team, we've done both halves of it. As a unit, we are licensed.
We are now licensed.
We could have a Top Gear license with all our faces on it.
Together.
Yeah, that's all right, yeah.
No!
Oi! We brought in that.
I am sorry, James, I am.
You're not sorry, please shut up.
This is somebody with a Nissan Micra.
Perfect.
There you are. And then I'm guessing here, Jag.
A6.
Cock. Then, oh my God, what kind of an idiot am I, James? What?
I know it's you.
We're up to 40 miles an hour in the Baygo. It's Chase. Come on!
was asleep.
Where's May?
Packing him on the throne. Clarkson, it's not funny.
Clarkson, you infantile pillock. You're tidying that up.
Why is that so hot? Is that glue? Why is it so hot? My suit! I've dropped hot glue on my suit! Do you have anything to cure super glue burns through silk? I've got my hand in the front of my trousers. Don't read anything into that.
Oh.
The one thing Moreno Magnum can do is a hill start.
Now, we're not petty, but...
Drum roll, please!
He just clipped it on the way back. It was...
Oh, mate.
So close. Did you feel a...
It never moved an inch.
No, well, it doesn't.
You smashed my drum kit up.
It doesn't feel like
you
it's
smashed
moving.
My no, drum kit up.
This
out of the way, sorry.
This is heavy.
Darcy's head's come off again.
Don't touch it.
Okay.
Yes, it is dark.
Let's film something over here.
What's more, our repair job wasn't brilliant.
When he finds that his precious piano is propped up by a mountain of pornography, he is going to go ape. Okay, May, let it rock.
He'll be very good at this sort. He likes this sort of thing.
See, look, feeling in the power.
He's Jeremy.
Run.
Yes, run away. Keep the pawn! You can have that! I'm in gear! I'm grabbing!
So you simultaneously headbutted me in the gentleman's region and snapped the prow off a galleon. You complete numpty, Hammond.
After the crash, my friends were deeply concerned.
He's woken up stuck in a lorry cab with five firemen. It's fallen apart.
Oh, come on!
Shut up. Yeah, we left Saigon. Well, one thing I can absolutely guarantee is that my bike will made it.
It's been quite a journey, if that's the
that
way
That has
ends.
Been a journey, and it here has, is it? James May ending
Completing
it.
Completing it. I don't believe it. This is the worst arrival at a place ever made by anyone, James.
And it is quite a rugged, personable little thing.
Yes, it is, actually.
I mean, it is. I mean, it sort of quite... Give it a name.
It's got one, Neva. Do you think we've actually found a communist car that we like?
No.